Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Dragon Quest Builders! My name is Michael Batman Guy, and today I am in my tiny little dirt hut because... Well, because we started the world all over again. Or, oh, I forgot, I made a hole down here. We'll get to that later. Yeah, we're in the land of... What is this called again? Rimmeldar? Is there something that says where I am? Up here? Maybe this will tell me. Save file? Ah, Rimmeldar 01. Here we go, chapter 2. Okay, good. Been a while. Sorry the video is coming a bit late today. I'm trying to get ahead for next week, and that naturally puts me behind first before I can get ahead. But I have gone ahead and gotten a whole bunch of earth, so we've got lots and lots of dirt to play with. So before we check out what, I forget your name already. Before we see what her quest is that she has in mind, I'm going to begin clearing this out. Of course, I need to get more mallets. I spent 2 whole mallets worth wiping out... see that kind of flattish land right there above my head? Right there. Yeah, that used to be a hill, much like that one over there in the distance. No, it's not. I squished it flat. Mahaha! Now the dirt is mine! And this has to go. And this has to go. Oh, the bag is full. Okay, let's put some things away. First, replace these in... Well, I don't want to put anything in there. That'll kind of... de-bedroomify the bedroom. Kinda still need a bedroom. There we go, quick fire. Let's go ahead and make another chest. Or two, if we can. Ah, just branches. We got plenty of branches. Make 2 of those. There we go. Put one, right here. And we can put one in here. Sure, why not? Alright, where are they? Get back! Get out of here! Go on, nobody likes you! Wow, her rocks are really good. She's doing more damage than I was. Why don't you defend the town? And I'll, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I was gonna say, I'll mend the med bay, but no, you're probably better at that too. Why don't you become the builder? Clearly more qualified. Oh, right, I can actually build things. Alright, I suppose I'll do the building. If you insist, I guess. Got one job. Smash rocks. Break skulls. Campfire can stay. This tree, this has to go. I still have no idea where we're gonna find some tree saplings. If we could locate some of those, that would be great. Can I break this? Yes. Yes, I can. Good. And bag is full already. Let's go ahead and start filling this sucker up. Actually, I need to empty the other one. Before I can get rid of this stupid hill right here. Oh, that's quite a mess. That's quite a mess. Did you see that, like, rainbow? Shimmer. I wish this had the little Terraria quick sort kind of button. That would be really useful. Okay, take all the things. Put the chest somewhere useful. And throw the rest of the junk inside. There we go. Good as new. As for you, I'm gonna go ahead and let's take, well, we'll get some dirt when we take this down, so don't worry about it. Stick. Skull. Power attack! Yay, got wooden steps. Two more, maybe? Yeah! Alright. Hill decimated. Now the question becomes, what plane do we actually want to build this in? And I'm just gonna tear all this up so it's no longer purple. In fact, you know what? To save space, we don't even need this here. Sure, we'll put the stairs around it. That's fine. In fact, sure. We'll just do this. Yeah, that'll look neat, I suppose. Do we want to take everything down one more level? Down to this floor. Probably be better. And I gotta move the chests again! Ah, what a pain. Of course, moving this up. This counts as ground level. This is where I can actually spawn the water. We tested that device last time. Definitely want to get rid of them. Come on. Super attack. There we go. Gotta get rid of that, for sure. Leave. How much space do I want to leave? I want to push this wall out, because this is just a waste of space. But I'm thinking taking it all basically down to ground level, and like this wall, this can go. We can fit another room over here. I want to go, yeah, kind of keep this, two spot. Oh dear. My bad. Keep that there. And this just becomes the outer wall. Right? Yeah, okay. Face that way, please. Thank you. Make it a little easier. So that's the idea there. Hey! Who do you think you're messing with, huh? Huh, that's what you get. That's what you get! Should we go to sleep? We should eat, that's what we should do. Do eat. And get bonked on the head. Bonk you on the head. Yeah, that's great. That's what you get for messing with me. I'm not gonna like this. Really not gonna like this. Okay. Although we do have the distinct advantage of getting rid of just go die, and I should probably take a nap just for the heals, I suppose. Though, actually, I want to see. We've got nicer beds in the, what is it called? The sick bay? Sick room? Sick room. Yeah. Why don't I try the comfy beds? That would be more sensible, wouldn't it? And we need more mallets. That's for sure. Far more mallets than you could possibly imagine. Well, I don't know, maybe you can imagine a lot of mallets. Oh, just smash it all. There we go. Good riddance. No, I still want that. I need to be able to get up here. So, let's put a little something around the edges. like so. I think I can jump right under there. Yeah, that doesn't get in the way. Okay. That. And like that. There we go. Alright. Everything else is on clearance. It must go. Ah, smash it. Smash it all. No, let's not break this yet. We'll break that later. There we go. There. And there goes the mallet. It's okay. Got plenty more where that came from. Got 16 branches. We'll just make a trifecta of mallets. Oh, we can just punch the grass. There you go. Ha! There we go. All re-equipped. Busted. Earth. Let's see if we can do this without wrecking the room. A little trim off the side here. Yes, much better. We'll come back to the rest of it later. Right now, I want to focus on the outer wall. Just get this hooked up so nothing can bother us ever again. Ever again. Outside, in, two, yes, okay. So, here's the edge. Yeah, that bedroom's gonna have to go. We'll just... We will leave an idea of the bedroom there. Do we have three wide doors? No, not yet. I think even the big steel doors were... like four wide. There's no odd number door. Except for the little jail cell. We had that cell door. Could use that, but again, later, not now. So where do I actually want to put the door? That's a good question. Can't quite line it up with the flag, so do we go completely to the side? Let's go close enough, right here. I saw him. Where are you? Ah! You are no match! You are too slow! That's what you get for being a shellfish. Shell crustacean thing. I'm not sure what the terrestrial term is. Shell creature. Such as the snail. Out, in, to... Okay, wall. There we go. Do-do-do-do. Just keep building walls. And we'll have to see what kind of new material we get to clad these in now. I'd rather not have to do one and then tear everything down and start all over again like we did... Cantlin? Jeez, I've already forgotten their names. Ah, I think if we can get a double on each hit, this is actually a little faster than waiting for that spin move to charge up. But not by much. Ah, alright, nice and clear. Clean and clear and under control. That. Let's go ahead and make ourselves a door. Done. We should be relatively safe now. Alright, we've got a little crafting station here, a little bedroom over there. Not bad, not bad, I like it. And this thing in the middle, I guess, which will just kind of become like a central courtyard sort of deal. So I'm thinking we could... let's see here, let's just start planning out some rooms. If we just kind of go across like this, the door here, this goes to this room. Mm-hmm. There. This could become... this could probably be split into two rooms pretty easily. Yeah, that's not bad. Not a terrible size. Just go in, let's see. One, two... door, door, one, two, wall. And that's okay, and this would have one and one. Yeah, sure, they're not equal, but they're both then symmetrical. So we got that going for it. Of course, taking out this bedroom will give us all kinds of possibilities. And similar to... same, if you remember in Cantlin, we similarly had... the gate did not lead immediately into the courtyard. We'd have another room to get to the middle. And that might be like our armory, you know, for future reference. That might work well. What to do with this? Don't want to put the wall... if I extend this wall, it'll be right up against the water. Of course, I made the water that big in the first place. So, just fill that in. There we go. Not an issue. And then... okay, where do we go from here? How far do we have these? These are 1, 2, 3, 4 wide? Okay. We'll mimic that here. And, just go all the way across. 1, 2, 3, 4, wall. There we go. And doorway there. Something like this. I don't know, I'm just making this up as I go. These aren't the most efficient of rooms, but then again, I don't know what would be the most efficient space. If we wanted to squeeze in like a bunch of little... yeah, we should have like a barracksy kind of spot. Instead of just arbitrarily making some rooms, let's actually think this through. Start planning. I need to move this stuff again. rid of that stuff. This will be our center room. We've got 1, 2, 3 spaces. 1, 2, 3 spaces. So for the time being, this will be our work room, possibly later to become an armory. And I'm going to go ahead and make these doors off-center on purpose, because this is a defensive structure. We can't have things that just, you know, zip in on a straight line. Can't make it easy for them. Let me see here. Can I get this to fit? Yeah. There we go. That will do nicely. And Chess, you can stay where you are, actually. You'll just be incorporated into the wall for the time being. Until I can get my hands on whatever it was I needed for the colossal coffer. Or colossal cabinet? Wasn't that a thing? Am I making this stuff up? Coffer. Yeah, okay. Wood, still haven't found any trees. Fur, still haven't found any hammer hoods. Pot is still just earth and blue goo, right? Yeah, I can make some of those. That'd be fine. You know what? Let's make one. And, ooh! Do I still know how to make the potter's room? I should do that. Yeah. Let's do that, actually. Maybe here in the corner would be a good place for it. Or in here. Actually. Let me get another door. Seal this thing off. There we go. And how many pots do we need? 4, 5? 4? And a chest? 3, 4. 5. Oh, we already had one. Okay. We'll put that right. No, I've learned my lesson. Do not put it next to the workbench, otherwise, that's where everybody will be. Hooray! It's a carpenter's workshop! Well-equipped workroom where willing woodworkers can work wood. Residents will build furniture and materials and put them in the chest. Okay, maybe I want a different room then for the pots. Nuts. Gonna need another door. Unless we don't need this bedroom. Yeah, who needs a bedroom? Forget it. Beds are overrated. What we want is a pot chamber. For the chamber pots, I mean. No, just break that. Put everything in here. There we go. Nice and full. And pot chamber. Excellent. Okay. Okay, progress. Progress. We've got something going now. Now, what do we want to do with the rest of this space? Let's see here. For efficiency's sake, I believe we can have two things sharing. Whoa! Okay. Yeah. That's right. Not only do you have a ranged attack, you have a lobbing ranged attack that can go over walls. You have to die. Ha! That jerk. Okay. Let's see here. As I was saying, things should be able to share doors, right? We should be able to... Okay, bare minimum. Absolutely bare minimum. Mattress. Mattress. Let's see, do I want to go with width or length? Either make it 3 wide, like this, and we go wall along here, and I have to have a door, like, right there. Right? Absolutely teeny tiny, cramped little room. Or, whoops, mallet. Or, put the bonfire at the end, and then we can put wall along here, and the door goes right here. So you walk in, and there it is. Comfortable. 206. Oh, hey! There we go. Level 2. The door goes right into the fire. There is, I mean, you can put some decorations up on the wall. That technically works. And then, theoretically, we could put... another one in this same space, right? And then this becomes a door, and the next one, and so on down the line. I don't like that though. That's too ugly. That's too tiny. We're thinking too efficient here. Let's actually be decent people to our residents. I mean, we don't want people to come to town and say, hey, yeah, the population is reviving. This builder guy is bringing back humanity. It's really poor living conditions, but hey, it's... well, it's not really any better than we had. It's horrible and cramped and damp, and we don't like it. Alright, we'll do something like this. Get a little separation between the two. Ooh, cozy. And we leave them a block of space at their feet. Then, maybe they won't hate us. And we could have that. And it's still 260 points. This guy. Come here, you. Come on, face me. Ready to go. Alright, fine, disappear like a coward. See if I care. Ah, see? Now they're like, oh good, we have a bedroom again. I can sleep. Yeah, I don't know why you can't sleep in these beds, but hey, you know, I'm going to. Let's give it a try, right? Sleep. Oh, it's so soft. So cozy. I miss Pippa. Alright, back to work. Anyways, we wasted a lot of space with that hallway. And so, if we just had a series of rooms that just connected straight into each other, and accessed them, you know, by accessing the others, like, we could just make this some completely different room. And what we would do here... is, let's see, how wide is this? 1, 2, 3? It's 1, 2, 3? Yep. 1, 2, 3? No. No, right there. Get out of here. And we would just go along like this. This would just be the bedroom, corridor of bedrooms, I suppose. Two, three, right there. Yeah, take out this wall. And this thing is doing nothing. At the end, we would have, like one more right here. This would be the last room. Maybe I want to turn them sideways. I mean, they're 3x3. They're rotationally symmetrical. What if you went like that? There we go. Now we can actually come in. I forget how these things place. I want... no. There we go. That way, yeah, it's gonna, obviously it's gonna swing over something, but the idea is that you would walk along here, right, and the hinge would be up there, okay. Can we get to this room very easily? No. Which means, is it great for when I have to get to sleep? No. But that's what we have this for. I'll probably make this smaller. Some point, because yeah, it matches the blueprint now, but is anybody gonna say boo if I were to change it after I completed the quest? I don't think so. Shh, don't tell her. She might say boo. How do we want to finish this off? I've got 2 blocks of space. This is not enough. Well, I guess technically it is enough. I could put a, you know, a door across here, and we could have one last little room on the end. We could have a last little hallway. We could have one larger room on the end. We could have the last one. The last one is this one. If we seal that up and make the door out the side, we could do that. But again, then what do we do with this space? I think we take that idea but move it up one. Rid of that, and we'll do like we had before, and bring this in over there, and then we've got this room of something. Yes, okay. Now we're getting nice and space efficient. Got a room there, We've got our quite sizable courtyard, which could be shrunk. We've got room to expand, right? We could put in a room in here, this kind of region. We could put another room in front of the sick room if we had to. We could split off the sick room if we had to. I think this'll do. Yeah. This'll work. This'll work nicely. One thing I do want to do. Take out this tree. And basically take out this room. Yeah. This thing just has to go. Smash all the pottery! Break it all. Smash it. Smash it to smithereens. Because it's too high up and in the way and awkward and dumb. It's a stupid room. Of course. And now I can't get up there to reach those things. Dang it. That's not where I wanted it. But okay. This out. No more purple. Purple is the color of the sick and dying world. We need to bring green back. Which means I want those grass seed things, which are dropped by. Whoa, look out! Under attack, where do you think you're going? What are you doing, lady? Where are you going? Look out, monsters! Seriously, you're the nurse. You're the white mage. You're the healer. Get back and heal. What are you doing on the front lines? 11 damage, that's what. 11 damage per rock. I can do 4 with my club. We are in desperate need of an equipment upgrade. That is for sure. Also, a food upgrade. I am tired of munching beans all day. This is ridiculous. Oh my goodness. How many beans do I have left? Just make all of them. They don't last. Hi, come on in. Oh, you can't. Oh, it's a door. Your greatest weakness. Aha! I've learned to dodge. Ooh, he drops chimera feathers too. That's helpful. Because I don't have to go climbing the giant mountains to find chimeras. Of course, I don't really need the warp wing until after I'm climbing giant mountains. But we'll worry about that later. Important thing is, we have a chest to put our stuff in. Ooh, wait, nope. I need that. Yeah, we need all of this. Because we're gonna go ahead and connect these walls to make let's see here do that And that. And I'm thinking pot chamber requires one chest. We make like a bare minimum kind of pot chamber here. Ta-da! Like so. We could make it smaller if we stacked them on top of each other, I'm sure. Yeah. But, you know, where's the fun in that? Raining? Seriously? Seriously, game? I was having such a great day. Go ahead and seal that off. Probably... we need a lot of doors. Just regular size workshop, and then this will become another room and another time. Yeah, I need the light source, but I really don't care about points at this point. I care about the setup, the preparation. I want a taller wall. That's the other thing I want. Let me get some dirt. That too, yeah. We can go ahead and decorate. This can go on top of there. Sure, why not? Gotta do something with them. And now we can access the wall. For a three high wall all the way around the outside. For additional security purposes, of course. I don't know if this will be tall enough to stop that snail. Or if I need to go for four. But this should at least reduce the narrow the range. Which he can shoot, right? You know what? We don't want your purple here. We don't serve your kind here. Get out of here, purple. There's another one. Oh dear. Let's go back here, because I don't want to break the room. That's such a pain. There we go. Purple eliminated. Do-do-do-do-do-do. No, we'll just even three all the way around. Maybe I'll add a fourth one between episodes. But we're almost done here. I think this will be a nice footprint to get started with. It's vaguely what they gave us to start with. I really liked how in Cantlin I've seen from the little bits and, you know, screenshots and things I've seen of other people doing this, some people decided to completely demolish what they had started with in Cantlin. That's basically what I've done here. I really didn't want to work around a giant hill. That's really impractical, and I really started running out of space at the end there. Bringing this down onto one level simplifies things a great deal. I kind of kept this. I mean, these suggested walls, of course, I have to rebuild them because blueprints are stupid in this game. And this... perhaps that wall? Oh, that wall was right here. Okay, so if I had gone with the really skinny rooms down here, the bear... what am I trying to say here? The bare bones serving. We would have had that same wall, plus, you know, the outer defensive wall. But now I think we've gotten to a reasonable point of functionality and expandability and defendability. And that's really where we want to be, after all. So, with that... can I make any more healing cream? One is... really worse. Oh, good. Yeah, that's... oh, I feel so much better. We've got healing, we've got food, we've got dirt. Let's go ahead and, again, nobody uses doors. They just jump on top of things. So, what do you got for me, El?
Really? You will help me, Batman? Robus be praised for sending such a willing disciple. I beg your pardon? You didn't say anything of the sort? Forgive me, I fear I was so caught up in the excitement of my new sick room, I only heard what I hoped to hear.
But I totally would help you. Sure, you name it. I'll go do it.
But be that as it may, after the wonderful work you did with that room, I have another request for you. Now that we have a sick room for all the ill and injured to recuperate in, we must bring them here and help them to get better.
Oh good, this will be the hospital chapter. I like it.
Some time ago, I saw a man who had fallen ill with the blight a little way to the west. Alas, I didn't have the medicines I needed to soothe his troubles. Though he may be too weak to walk, Batman, I'm sure a strong fellow like you would be able to carry him here. Please, my lamb, use your compass to find this poor soul and lay him to rest in the sick room.
I'm glad she added that, in the sick room. Lay him to rest. He's gone. It's too late. Give him a proper burial. New quest marker. Alright. Well, now would be a completely terrible, horrible time to go out adventuring into... oh, we gotta go that way? Wait, what? How are we supposed to go that way? There's nothing but... can I make a bridge over there? Or am I going to get blocked by plot wall? Okay, where are the monsters that are supposedly attacking my base? They are also that way. Okay. It's a 2-for-1 sale. To the west. Come here, you. Ow. Dang it. Ow. No, get back! Back! Back, I say! Alright. Nope, stop it! I'm the builder! I'm building! Leave me alone! Alright, let's see what we can do. Oh no. We've got ghosts in the goo. Ah! Missed. This is bad. This is like... bad. Let's make it double wide. And then... Can we... we can't place a block there. Can't place a block there. Can't place it in midair. Aha! We can get over the top of the branch this way. I really don't want to test if we can... if I can jump onto that. I have no idea how to jump back off. So far, so good. This is scary. Is he still following me? Yes, yes he is. But hey, we made it! Haha, land! Come here, you. Take that! Ha! We got him! Beat those buggers at their own game. There appears to be absolutely nothing up here. Be using a mallet. Nothing. Okay. Ooh, what's that over there? Sleeping slimes? Ah, there's our man! If the game meant for us to go around, well, screw that. I took the shortest route possible and built a bridge. Maybe we'll have to fancy this up. We'll have to make it a nicer looking bridge. Of course, definitely keep the too wide theme. Oh, maybe we could... ooh, that'd be cool. If we stick with the bridge, you can go back there. I don't like you. And stick with dirt. Right, too wide bridge leads to too wide tunnel through the hill here, which has a... whatever this poisonous peat is for a core. Oh, that's just great. This would be kind of cool, though. Expand it out a little bit. Yeah, this is not bad at all. Oh, this is nice. This is really nice. I can just kind of really easily switch from one side to the other. All right, I won't bother you if you don't bother me. Okay, we'll come to that agreement. Except I might need to bother the slimes. So I think they're the ones that drop the grass seeds. That's goo. I need grass, man. I want to grow some grass. Please. It's so purple! Hey! Hey you! Hey, person! Hey! Hey! Hey, listen! Can't see your face. Oh, darn it, camera. Trying to zoom in on the guy. Alright, we'll just have to make something up.
Who are you? You're not from around here, are you? My name's Nosh. There's nothing you can do for me. Just leave me alone and let me die in peace.
Hey, that's no way to talk. I've got a sick room.
What? You have a place to rest? Not far from here? I don't have the strength to walk. I'm sorry, but... could you carry me?
Let's see... Yeah, sure. Let's go for it. One arm! That's right. I am the builder. I'm just that strong. We'll just hoist him up. One arm.
I can grab a man and hold a man with a single arm and leap
tall buildings in a single bound, jump like a meter into the air. Because I'm Batman. I mean, the Builder. Builder Batman. Batman the Builder. Can we do it? Let's find out. Alright. Where do you want me to drop off your sack of potatoes? Right here? Alright, into bed with you.
Need medicinal herbs.
I don't have any of those. Hey, I got the dude.
Praise be to Rubus, Batman! You've brought me a patient! From his pained expression, it looked like he lost every ounce of his strength. It seems he suffers from the same sickness that affects so many here. Some slowly waste away until they grow so weak they perish. Others cough ever more severely until they cannot even breathe and succumb that way. In others, the disease eats away at them from the inside until their very bodies rot and fall apart. The vile contagion presents in so many different ways.
This is really disturbing. I thought this was a kid's game.
But we need not find a cure for every form of the illness just yet. For now, Batman, all I ask is that you help me save this one poor soul.
Alright, we'll do it with the power of strong stalks. Yeah, need medicinal armor. He's got like... It looks like a meter, see? It very much resembles our base meter. See, right there. If I can get him right on top of... Right... Oh, almost. Hit up a little more. Okay, you get the idea. Yeah, some kind of meter to fill. I can make two. That's... not that great. Hey man, you okay? Here, have a medicinal herb. Ba-ding! Oh! That was easy. Nausea's fully cured. That's it? Just one? Well, that seems a little too simple. So, what do you want me to do next? Give him medicinal herbs? I tried that.
Batman, my lamb! There is a reason the blight runs rampant through Rimmeldar. It is all due to the Hades Condor, who rules the roost over this entire island.
Is that the roost right above my head? That kind of towery thing? No, that'd be too easy.
If we ever wish to see the skies cleared, or the poison purified, this demon bird must be slain. It's said that the root cause of the blight that grips Rimmeldar is the fell rain that the condor summons forth. So by bringing that to an end...
Yeah, got it. Stop the bird, stop the rain, stop the poison. Makes sense.
What's that you say? Shouldn't we help that patient before we start dealing with the root cause?
Maybe. I don't see, I'm not the medical expert. I'm relying on your expertise here. If, trying to cure him is futile until the root cause is, well, rooted out. Maybe we should just go about that and not waste our time.
Oh, how right you are! Goddess, forgive me, for I am a wretched sinner. I've let my anger towards the monsters get the better of me. Batman, we must see to our new patient immediately. Judging from his symptoms, it seems the illness is still in its early stages. If we could just restore his vitality, he should be able to recover by his own strength. A pouch or two of medicinal herbs should be enough to get him back on the road to recovery. I shall watch over our poor patient and make sure his condition doesn't deteriorate. Would you be so kind as to prepare and administer the medicinal herb?
Sure. Consider it done.
Oh, hey, look, it's done. Oh, Batman, you've given our patient the medicine he so desperately needed. Goddess be praised.
Well, I mean, he did kind of have this, like he was talking in his sleep. I just had the feeling that that's exactly what he needed. Again, I'm no medical expert, but, you know, in a metaphysical sense, he was speaking to me.
His symptoms should start to subside soon. All he needs now is a good night's sleep and he'll be back to full strength. However, my lamb, I fear that our battle with the Blight has only just begun. I don't know what horrors we will see before it has ended. Our first patient's symptoms were particularly mild. I can only pray that all the others will be so easy to cure. Ah, but forgive me, I'm getting ahead of myself. I should instead be praying that our patient makes a speedy recovery. Remember, Batman, that when you treat a patient, they will still need time to recover their strength. I imagine most patients will recover with a good night's sleep. There's no harm in getting some sleep yourself while you wait for them to get better.
All right. So, next up, take a nap. And actually, I'm going to go ahead and wrap it up here. As I said, I'm going to go ahead and pop that outer wall up to 4 blocks high, and then we will be back to see what new developments await Mr. Sick Guy over there. Did we get a name? N something. Nate? Ned? I don't remember now. I'm so terrible with names. Just when I finally got used to Pippa and Rolo and... No, okay, never mind. I don't remember the rest. Already forgotten them. Moving on. This is Chapter 2, Rimuldar, the Lake of Poison and Horrible Diseaseness. I don't like it. I don't like it one bit. But we're going to get through it. I still love the game. It is still just as wonderful to play as ever, even if the new setting is a bit depressing. So stick with me. We'll make it through. We'll find that jungle area that the preview video promised. And then we'll have lots of fun in a tropical zone. Right, this is a temperate zone, coconuts tropical, see what we can do from there. My name is Michael Batman Guy, thank you very much for watching, I'll see you next time!